This is the house where I was born. Where I played with my siblings. I was the fourth child out of seven children. Very lucky, they said. I became blind at the age of 9. At the market when I fell. Everything became dark. My mother rushed me to the hospital. She begged the doctors to cure me. It was hopeless. I was permanently blind. But my mother saw me just the same. She never gave up on me. I was angry at the world. I cried all the time. I felt betrayed. I had a visitor one day. She wanted me to enroll in her blind school. I refused. I refused her many times. Finally, after the 10th time, I agreed to study there. Elizabeth Choi, she guided me. I found a job as a telephone operator near Sims Avenue. I had to cross a huge junction to get to work. I was afraid to cross the road. Then, one morning, I heard a voice from a stranger.
Boleh saya tolong awak puan?
May I help you cross the road? he asked.
Tak payah. Terima kasih.
I was scared, so I said no.
Jalan raya sendiri sibuk, Puan. Bahaya untuk Puan seberang.
Then he gave me his arm to hold. We spoke Malay to each other. After that day, he came to help me cross the road every day. Sometimes, I would forget to tell him that I was on leave. But he would still wait for me. Once, he even chased after the bus because I missed my stop. He ran after the bus. He was very often scolded for being late for work because of me. Rain or shine, this went on for 5 years till we parted ways. I was transferred to another location for work. And I lost touch with him soon after. Many years later, he came to my mother's funeral. He did not say much that day. And that was the last time we met. I received a call one evening. He had passed on. I rushed to his funeral. But I was late. They had already brought him to the cemetery for the burial. It was over when I got there. I never got to meet him for the last time, to say what I wanted to tell him. Terima kasih. Terima kasih. Terima kasih.